So we're again talking about Ramsey theory for graphs. And I'll give the definition one more time. The Ramsey number, the minimum n, such that for every coloring, the edges of the complete graph with two colors, there is either a copy of G in blue or a copy of H in red. And the theorem you were supposed to prove by yourselves was the Ramsey number of the triangle versus the tree is, I'm going to use K. For every tree with K vertices. Okay. Okay, so who managed to prove the theorem? Conseguiu? No? 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 Ninguém? Okay. Okay, so now you can prove it. It's not so hard. So, I don't need to help you. We're going to do the same thing we did last time. How would you go about proving the Ramsey number of the triangle and the tree is 2k minus 1? Okay, so first the easy part. Why is it at least 2k minus 1? So we want to show that if n is smaller than this, if it's 2k minus 2, then there exists a coloring with no blue triangle and no red tree. So what's the coloring? On a coloring of 2k minus 2 vertices, the complete graph. Thank you. Right. This is our coloring, right? K minus 1 vertices in each part. So there's no blue triangle, because blue is bipartite. There's no red tree on K vertices, because there's no connected graph on red graph on K vertices. Right? Okay? Okay. Okay. So how about the slightly harder part? We have to show that if you have 2k minus 1 vertices, and you've got a coloring two coloring of the edges of the complete graph on n vertices. Very good. Yeah. And? So, but it matters which color now, right? Because the colors are no longer symmetric. So which one? Blue. Okay. Inside here. Yeah, we're triangle free, so there's no blue, so this is entirely red. So therefore, this set has size... Yeah, sorry, so I guess I should draw the whole partition. And draw all of the vertices. So given any vertex V, you can look at its blue neighborhood and its red neighborhood. And we know inside here we're entirely red. Okay? Otherwise we have a blue triangle. And we know what? Yeah. If there were k vertices here, we would have a red tree on k vertices. Yeah. If a red complete graph on k vertices, so it contains every tree. So here we must have at most k minus 1, which means here... Sorry? 1, k minus 1, yeah, k. Okay, so what have we proved? Okay. We've shown that the red degree of every vertex is at least k. Now, cast your memories back in time. What can you tell me about graphs with minimum degree k and trees on k vertices? Ah, sorry now. What am I talking about? 2k minus 1, k minus 1. None of us can count. Okay? There's a lemma from a long time ago. Let T be trees are masculine. Is that right? No. Okay. If the minimum degree of a graph is at least k minus 1, what does that imply? Implies that T is a subgraph of G. Right. Uh-huh. Very good. There's only... They're surprisingly powerful basic tools. Okay.
I remember I went to construct the graph and you said, no, you can do it by induction. So I really remember.
So k equals 1 is okay because t is just a single point. k equals 2 is okay because t is just a single edge. Okay, so how do you do the induction step? So what's a good way of doing induction with trees? Remove a leaf. No. Okay. So suppose it works for k minus 1. Let's prove it for k. So we know that t has leaves. We proved it. We're going to take a leaf. This is t. Remove this leaf. We're left with t prime. We know that we can find t prime inside G by induction. And then we have a vertex that needs a neighbor, but this vertex in G has degree k minus 1, and there are only k minus 2 vertices here, so he must have a neighbor outside. Okay. Okay? Okay. Cool. So we're done, right? We showed either we have a blue triangle, or we have a red clique of size k, or every vertex has red degree at least k minus 1, in which case t is contained in gr. Okay. So it was not so hard. Okay. What's next? So the most natural next thing. You've done all trees. Let's try a cycle. So first note that our lower bound always works, right? A triangle against anything will always work. Any, I guess, connected graph. Okay? So it's certainly bigger than 2k minus 1. Is it equal to 2k minus 1? I think you also know how to do this. Yeah? Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So, Yeah, so this still works. So we don't have this lemma. So the question is, if G has minimum degree at least k minus 1, and the number of vertices of G is equal to 2k minus 1, does this imply that ck is contained in G? That's what we want. We have, this is the red graph. It's on 2k minus 1 vertices. We have minimum degree k minus 1. So why? It looks a lot like Dirac's theorem, right? Dirac's theorem says if the minimum degree is bigger than n over 2, which is not quite, then you contain a Hamiltonian cycle. We don't need a Hamiltonian cycle. We just need one on k vertices. So, well, we know we can find a path on k vertices, right, by the previous lemma. But you've still got k minus 1 vertices outside. That's a problem. What should we do? So for Dirac's theorem, what we did was we said, look, take a maximal path, and you can find vertices like this that turn into a cycle. But the trouble is we don't now know how many edges these vertices send back in. Right? They could be all, yeah, they could all go down here. So what to do? So first observation, let's check that it's true for small values. So how about k equals 3? Yeah, so the Ramsey number of K3 against K3, yeah, which is not equal to 2 times 3 minus 1. Slight problem. There is an alternative. If it gets any better. Are 7 vertices enough to make C4? Well, we can assume that the degree in red is at least 3. Right? Therefore, we find 4, the inverse has 3 edges. So you all did the example sheet, right? We have 7 vertices, and everyone has degree at least 3. What does that tell you about the maximum degree of GR? So we know the maximum degree. We've got maximum G tem que ser no mínimo 3. É possível que todos os vértices tenham grau 3? Todos os 7 vértices têm grau 3?
Não.
Não, né? Ok. That helps a bit. Right? You know, they can't all have degree 3 because then we'd have an odd number of edges. Not an odd number of edges. Odd number of sum of degrees. Half number of edges. Okay. So now we have a vertex with red degree 4. And now we have lots of ways of making C4s, right? If any vertex here has 2 neighbors, red neighbors above, we have a C4. Right? So every vertex, both these vertices, have at least 3 blue neighbors up. which means that none of these guys can be blue. You only need one guy, right? Say one of these vertices if he has two red neighbors, we have a C4, so he has three blue neighbors, but these three edges now, or these two edges in particular, cannot be blue, so they're red. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So, for 4, it's true. Any conjectures? False for 3, it's true for 4. What do you expect for 5? Seems one valid conjecture. Conjecture one. Okay. Any rival conjectures? Rival conjecture? Or everyone believes this conjecture? Okay, let's see. Try 5. So what are the two rival numbers? 9 and 10. So can you give me a construction on 9 vertices, or can you prove that 9 vertices is sufficient? Well, let's see. Maybe we try and prove it, and by failing to prove it, we'll see what the construction has to look like. So take a vertex. So the minimum degree is now at least 4, right? By the same argument. Because now we don't know the maximum degree is bigger. It could be 4 regular. So suppose all the vertices have degree 4. Red and blue. And this is a clique. That's a pretty good start. We've got a complete graph on four vertices. This is if everyone has degree four, or if someone has degree four. So if anyone sends two red edges into there, then we're happy. Right? Okay, so what we've done is we've taken the vertex. Take a vertex. Look at its neighborhood. Look at its non-neighborhood. Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. So nobody sends two red edges into here. So they all send three blue edges. Okay. Why not? And it seems pretty likely then that this guy at the bottom will also be a red clique. Because if every vertex here sends three edges up, on average, vertices here send three edges down. Blue edges. Yes? No. No, not so happy. Draw the picture again. So, the vertex here. This is his blue neighborhood, and this is his red neighborhood. His blue neighborhood is a red clique. Okay. So we suppose. There exists a vertex with blue degree 4. Okay. If a vertex down here sent two red edges up, we'd be done. Right? So every vertex on the bottom sends at least three blue edges up. That means there's 12 blue edges going up. So there's 12 blue edges arriving at the top. So on average, they send out three. If any of them sends out four, then this would be a red clique. Right? In which case we'd be done, because this vertex sends all red to this one. So we have our five cycle. No? Yeah? Yeah? This is a red clique. Then we're done. Yeah. Okay. So suppose not. If not, everybody sends three reds down. Three blues down. Okay. So, how to finish? We want to find a five cycle on these five vertices. Suppose, let's try and prove it's a red clique. Suppose one of these edges is blue. Ah, it's already silly. Sorry, I didn't even need any of that. Sorry, it's already completely obvious. Let's go back a step. Okay. Each of these vertices sends three blue edges up. I claim this is a red clique. Why? Suppose there's a blue edge. well, this guy has three blue neighbors. This guy has three blue neighbors, so they must have a neighbor in common. By Casdubonbo. Okay? So this doesn't happen. Therefore, all of these things are red, and this is red as well. So we found our five cycle. Actually, a five clique. Okay, that was this case. So suppose not. Then the red degree is at least five for every vertex. And therefore, we can try. How many more vertices? There's nine in total. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, so we said we know that the blue degree is at most four. Yeah. And we dealt with the case that there exists a vertex of degree four, and we solved it. So now we're trying to do the case where all blue degrees are at most three. That probably should be enough to give us what we want. But why? Well, this is not a blue triangle, so there's a red edge here. Now, if these vertices have disjoint neighbors, so if they send one here and one here, then we have a five cycle. So that doesn't happen. So that means they can only have at most one neighbor, which means all of the others they send blue to. Or at least one of them sends blue to the others. But now this is a red clique, so we found our five cycle. So we're done. Okay. So the answer was 9, and the conjecture is false. So, new conjecture. There we go. Yeah, exactly. Okay. So, let's try and prove this. I'm pretty sure this is true, so I'll call this a theorem. Okay. So, suggestions. The hope is that we've basically done the hard work and things will get easier from now on, I guess. Yeah. Seems reasonable, right? But well, are we going to assume this for every vertex or just one vertex? We only seem to need it for one vertex, so maybe that's enough. And then how many vertices do we have left? K minus 2. We're looking for a K cycle. This isn't looking too hopeful. How are we going to find a K cycle in here? Perhaps this is not the right case to start with. We start with a vertex of blue degree k minus 1, and therefore red degree k minus 1 as well. I'll do it red. And then we have this nice k minus 1 red clique. Looks good. Now what? Now it looks like we can just repeat this proof, right? If any vertex sends two red edges up, then we're done. So every vertex at the bottom sends k minus 2 blue edges up. Every vertex does this. So can there be a blue edge in the bottom? No way, right? K minus 2 plus k minus 2 is way bigger than k minus 1. If k is bigger than 3. Okay. So that tells us that, in fact, this is a red clique, which means we can add this vertex, and we have, a red clique on k vertices. Okay. So that was nice, but it wasn't. We didn't use the full power of the argument, right? We were a little. When k is large, then this inequality is not tight. So could we do something a bit better? Okay, suppose there's a vertex with blue degree k minus 2 instead. Now we need to add two vertices in the bottom, but this is a clique, so we can add them in basically any way we like. Right? There's not a lot of... The only problem, if they send... Suppose they both sent two red edges up. The only problem would be if those two red edges landed in the same spots. Right? This guy adds two edges, so you can add him. This guy adds two edges, but maybe they're the same edges, and maybe the one between them is blue. Well, that can't be the case, because k is at least... Well, if k is at least 5 or something... No, just a k... Yeah, if k is at least 5, k minus 2 is at least 3, so there's another vertex, and then you'd have a blue triangle. So what? What should we do? Okay, it's not entirely clear. Perhaps we can try to push from the other side. What red degree would be sufficient? So what does that imply? Okay, so we're going to take a blue edge, remove these two vertices, and we have a coloring on 2k minus 3 vertices. So we have either a blue triangle or a red cycle on k minus 1 vertices. And then each of these sends down at least k . So outside this cycle, there are k minus 2 vertices. So each of these has two neighbors inside here. But yeah, that's not enough. Yeah, so induction is a reasonable idea. Removing two vertices is a reasonable idea. Is there any way to make it correct? So what would be sufficient? What degree here would be sufficient to make this argument work? I think what you probably want to do is take a go with a red edge between them. And you want to try to add both of them to this cycle. And so what you need is for them to have adjacent neighbors, right? Which means you need them to have at least k minus 2 to go to the rest, plus k minus 1 over 2 red edges, right? Plus this one, right, so in here you have to have that many, so here you should have that plus 1. So you should have at least 3 over 2 times k minus 1. And then it seems to work. When k equals 4, this is the same as 9 over 2, which equals 5, which is encouraging because that's what we used for this case in the case k equals, reduce k equals 5. That's one too many. Yeah, not quite encouraging. But for k equals 5, is it 4 at 6? It's 6. Okay. So maybe it's a little too weak. The thing is, we're using induction, and the induction hypothesis doesn't seem like it's as strong as it could be. Right? We found We're saying induction hypothesis says we can find one cycle. But actually, in the proof, we found a lot more than that. We found either a clique, or we found, well, okay, so maybe we only always found a cycle. We found lots of cycles. When we did it, we only necessarily found a cycle, but you know, with induction, you want sometimes something stronger. Sorry? Em vários casos a gente achou cliques, mas em outros casos não. Mas tem razão, o que a gente provou foi, parece mais poderoso do que isso. Esse é o nosso problema. Nosso problema é, a gente achou the case is giving us problems is when, so we take this guy. We find this cycle on k minus 1 vertices, and we have k minus 3 vertices left over, and maybe this sends red to the whole thing. But this gives us a lot of chance to then find a red cycle in this side, right? And maybe it only sends half as many over here. Yeah, so the problem with induction in this problem is we don't know what the right statement is. Right? We don't know what the correct induction hypothesis is. If we could find the correct induction hypothesis, maybe it would just go. But we don't know. Or at least we don't know. So it seems we have to be more hands-on. This picture still feels to me like our best bet. At least we have some clique. Okay, we don't know how big it is, but okay, let's let D be the maximum degree of the blue graph. Okay, so there's some D. That's the biggest degree we have. And we have this many vertices here. I guess we know that this is bigger than roughly k over 2 by this argument. sorry, at a slight thought as an alternative. Another possibility is to take this blue edge again and observe that then the blue neighborhoods of these two sets are disjoint. And then it says they send red edges everywhere else. And that these guys are red cliques. Is there a way to find a cycle here? Suppose a vertex down here has red neighbor in both sides. Can we add these vertices one by one? We know this thing is at least k over 2. We know this thing is at least k over 2. So don't we just need, isn't this already a k cycle? Okay, so. So, just very vaguely, let's go back here. So, suppose D is the maximum blue degree in B. Okay, so maybe I don't quite mean this. Let's pretend first that so, when you don't know what to do, often a good idea is to simplify things and prove special cases. Maybe it has the key. So suppose that the blue graph is D regular, so all the degrees are D, and that D is bigger than about K over 2. Okay? We think that this should be true, right? Right, by this kind of argument. Otherwise, you should be able to do something inductive. Take two vertices, which are joined by a blue edge, and look at their blue neighborhoods. They're disjoint, right? Right? And they're both red cliques. Now, suppose we have two vertices outside who each have a neighbor on the left and a neighbor on the right, and let's suppose they're not the same neighbors. I claim there's a K cycle inside here. Where is it? You go here, here, all the way around here, 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 all the way around here. Right? You can use all of the vertices. So as long as this is U and V, the blue degree of U plus the blue degree of V is at least K minus 2, and there exist two vertices like this, then we're done. Okay. Now, if there don't exist two vertices like this, then what? Well, we've still got quite a lot of vertices down here. Unless D is really big. And everyone in U and V both send only red to them. Now, suppose there's a blue edge down here. Well, we know that for every other vertex, one of these guys sends a red edge. Right? So unless it's always the same vertex on one side, in which case he should be in that clique, then you have what you want. Right? So for each blue edge, either one of the end vertices can be added to one of the sides and the other vertex to the other side. I guess, or this guy, one of the guys attached to both. Or you have what you want. So if we start out like this, then we add vertices to these red cliques if possible. What we're left with must be a red clique. Ah, so suppose, sorry. Yeah, let me redraw the same thing. For every vertex here, one of these two edges is red. But for every vertex here, it might be the same vertex. So it might be that we just have these are all red and these are all blue. That's possible. In that case, I'll just add this vertex to the clique, because it's still a clique. Right? If this vertex sends only red into this clique, we just have a bigger clique. Okay. It's not attached to this vertex by blue, but who cares? Right? It's just an extra... It just makes this clique bigger. We're not going to use these blue edges. So another thing we could do is use that these are red and these are red, right? We have lots of possibilities. Dun, 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 dun. Oh. Is that already enough? No, you can do it once. Okay. So, every time it happens that a vertex has only red to one of these cliques, I'll add it to the clique. Okay? So, I assume this doesn't happen. These cliques are maybe just a bit bigger now. So, we don't know these are all blue. There could be some red here as well, and some red here as well. But we do know that we have red here and red here. Right? Because when we move something, then well, it's red to both of these. Okay. So we have red here and red here. Because this was exactly the blue neighborhood of U, and V can't send any. V can't send blue edges here, because then you'd have a triangle. Okay. Now this doesn't happen. So there's always, for any blue edge down here, there's always two vertices. So that happens. And there's always two vertices such that that happens. Which means we'd be done. By the previous argument. Therefore, this thing is a red clique. So we've partitioned the vertex set into three red cliques plus these two vertices. This one might be empty. If it is empty, where? Here? No, no, I just showed if there's a blue edge, if there's a single blue edge anywhere, then there must be, because every vertex sends one red dot either here or here, there must be a vertex sends red here, and a vertex that sends red here.
But why
does blue edge exist? No, I'm showing it doesn't exist. Yeah, I claim it doesn't exist, so this is a contradiction.
Okay.
So you believe it doesn't exist?
Yes.
Okay, good. Because that's what I thought I'd proved. Right. Okay. So this is a red clique. Okay. So now we must be basically done, right? We have three red cliques. There's no way we can't find a cycle. Moreover, we have these helpful vertices here that send red edges here and here, and this sends red edges here and here. Right? Where's our cycle? One. No. No. Okay, so they're not much use. Anyway, let me draw this again. We draw these three guys. And they're red cliques. And there are these two extra vertices. Ah, but these vertices could be added to these cliques, right? They were allowed to be added. Right? Because they sent blue to one and red to the other. So in fact, we just have three red cliques.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're all because the blue edge doesn't exist. But yeah. Yes, that was the thing.
Okay.
So that was just the thing with finding the two edges going that way and two edges going that way, and you found your cycle, the green cycle. Yeah. When I drew it in green. Yeah, sorry. Red. Yeah, the red cycle that I drew in green, exactly. Okay, so how to finish it off? We've partitioned the set into three red cliques. Okay? The total number of vertices is 2k minus 1, and there's no blue triangle. How do we find a k cycle?
Which sides are the...
We don't know. Yeah, so suppose this is just one point, and this is, it is k we're done, so k minus 1 and k minus 1. It's a good special case. How do you finish it in this case? Yeah. So we have to use the fact there's no blue triangle, right? Otherwise, it could be blue, blue, and blue, and we'd be dead.
So there is
So I guess if you take this vertex in the smallest one, maybe it has size 1. If it has size 0, we're done, right? One of these has size k. Okay, so it has at least one vertex. Let's look at the blue neighborhood here and here. Or should I look at the red neighborhood? What do you think? The blue neighborhood has to be pretty big. But if you have, whatever size the blue neighborhood is, you have a complete red bipartite graph between them. So if this vertex has two blue neighbors here and two blue neighbors here, then you have your cycle, right? That goes through actually 2/3 of the vertices, because you can do green, right? Okay. So that means every vertex sends at most one blue edge to either left or right. Okay. So we can partition this bottom set into two pieces. The ones who send at most one blue edge here and the rest red. And the ones who send at most one blue edge here and the rest red. But that means that this is a clique minus a matching. Minus just some, each vertex sends one is up. So you can find a cycle inside here. It's almost a clique. And the same thing here. But one of these two is bigger than k, and so you're done. Okay. So I don't know if that's the easiest proof of that result. That was just the one that turned up. So just to finish, so I guess part of the point of that, apart from seeing how these arguments can work and how you go about trying to prove something like this, is to show the big difference that comes from going from trees to non-trees. Right? It's much harder to find cycles than it is to find trees. Okay? And it's because of this, trees have leaves. But it turns out this kind of proof, something more complicated, you can use to prove much stronger results. So, for example, it's still true that if you take the k-dimensional hypercube, so a k-dimensional hypercube, have I told you about this graph before? So Q2 is a square. Q4 is a three-dimensional, sorry, Q3 is a three-dimensional cube. Q4 is a four-dimensional cube, which is like two cubes sitting next to each other with a matching between them. 8 matching. And so on. So this is a k-dimensional cube. QK has 2 to the k vertices and 2 degrees are all k. Okay. So it's got degrees roughly log of the number of vertices. So this turns out to be exactly twice the number of vertices minus 1. Okay. And the extremal thing is exactly the same. Okay. The proof is quite a bit more complicated, And I guess I say, okay, this is for k at least 4. This is for k at least 2 to the 2 to the 2 to the 2 to the... I don't know, lots of times. K to the k times. Something like that. Is that right? No, sorry, what am I talking about? That can't be allowed. 2 to the 2 to the 2, some constant number of times. 10 to the 10 times. I don't know. So I got confused because there's also a more general theorem . So if you're avoiding not a triangle but a clique of size S, then the answer is S minus 1 times 2 to the K minus 1 plus 1. And the extremal thing is, take a Chirang graph. Each set has size 2 to the k minus 1, and there are s minus 1 of them. So there's no blue clique on s vertices, and no red graph on 2 to the k vertices. And this one is if k is bigger than 2 to the 2 to the 2 to the 2 to the 2, s to the s times, sorry, times something. So one last thing, it's also known for lots of bounded degree graphs, but it's not true for every sparse graph. Right? So you might think that it seems in every case we've looked at, this is the correct extremal thing if you take a sufficiently sparse graph H. It turns out if that graph is a so-called expander, which basically means it looks like a random graph, then it's false. No one knows the answer, but the Ramsey number is much bigger. So there's something interesting, even at this very sparse level, that if you put a graph here that looks structured, you get an answer like this. If you take a graph that's random-like, you get a different answer. And, I mean, this is very recent, so above this, we have no idea. Right, sorry, I stopped. So, Monday, I promise you, equations.